Namaste, assalamu alaikum, and no ia e Maori Fiji. To our special guests tonight, our women, our champs, who are here, who have fought the battle and won. And to also all our women and children who continue to fight the battle, and to those that have lost because of what they were facing. We acknowledge you and we pay tribute to you tonight. Your Excellency, the Ambassador of Britain, Dr. Brian, the Chief Medical Officer, Dr. Tundravu, the founder of the WOW's Walk On, Walk Strong Foundation, Sinakami, the CEO of the Fiji Cancer Society, Lynda, and to ladies and gentlemen who are here tonight. I have a personal story to tell myself. I lost my first friend, my best friend, my prayer warrior, my dear mother, to cancer. And it wasn't until 6 weeks before she died that she was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer, and there was nothing we could do. I've often wondered what I could have done better. I still wonder. I wonder if I could have been more in tune with her, a larger-than-life individual, someone who was always there to make everyone else happy, to make sure there was food always on the table when we came to her home, someone who served in various organizations, especially women, to empower their lives. What could I have done better to be there for her and to perhaps detect it way earlier? Maybe she knew. Maybe she knew all along, but she did not prioritize the care that she needed. There were a lot of maybes for me when she passed at 67. She didn't suffer much in the last 6 weeks. The only care that she needed when she was in hospital was that she needed draining from her lungs because the water kept filling up her lungs. But she was still her usual self, making us laugh, being brave when we went to visit her in the hospital, even until she walked into the theater for her operation and she never woke up again. She was like that. I believe my mother represents many, many women in our country. Women who take on the responsibility of looking after their families, of looking after their communities, of looking after the nation. Women who perhaps know that they are not well, but sometimes feel alone that they cannot come forward and get the help they need. I am here tonight, both personally and on behalf of the government, to commit to closing the care gap. I am here tonight because I believe in the very important work of the Fiji Cancer Society, as well as all the women and men and our children who rally around it to bring this most dreadful disease to the forefront. I thank the Grand Pacific Hotel. It's a typical Saturday night here at Albert Park. You can hear the music coming from the Albert Park Pavilion. But I sure hope that they are all on their feet dancing, because it's a very highly recommended form of exercise and physical activity that our people love to do. This morning we saw hundreds of people come together of all ages, of all backgrounds, converging here at Albert Park this morning to do the 5 kilometer walk. It was so encouraging to see many people come forward to be the faces and also to support this very important cause. To them, I say thank you very much. We hope that the next activity that the Fiji Cancer Society has planned for us, we will not only have hundreds, but we will have thousands of people. And that I hope to see more of my colleagues come and attend these events. Because the more of us that speak out, the more we use our platforms, including social media, including traditional media, and any platform that we have the opportunity to do, we need to speak up. We need to let our women and men and children know, if you're watching this from home and you are dealing with this most dreadful disease, if you are struggling with the pain, with the stigma, with the lack of care, but most importantly, if you feel that you are not being cared for, or that you are not worthy, or that you do not matter, you matter. Each of our women who are here tonight are the brave ones who have gotten through. They matter. So on behalf of the government of Fiji, on behalf of our ministry that is here as the Ministry for Women and Children, to support the Ministry of Health, to support the important work of the Fiji Cancer Society, to support the WILES Foundation, continue to fight on for our children, and to our donors, our important partners, Your Excellency, the British Ambassador, as well as to all those who have donated and continue to donate to this very important cause, I salute you. Because all those women and men and children who are watching, they will continue to feel that they are not alone. That we are here and committed to closing the care gap. I end with my prayers for you, that you will continue to be brave, continue to be bold, and that we who are around you will continue to show that support and care that you very much need. I look forward to the lighting of this beautiful hotel, this landmark in the Pacific, the Grand Pacific Hotel, or they call it the Grand Old Lady. What an apt venue for a lady to host this most important event, to advocate for women and to advocate for children. We need women and men to work together in peaceful nation building, to hand in hand continue to bring peace to our nation, and especially to our most vulnerable. To each of you who are here tonight, I wish to say thank you, Inakavakalevu, Danebad, Faixia, and keep fighting the fight. Thank you.